time. This is 1010 Wings.
Good morning, 62 degrees at 6 o'clock.
Back to sleep, baby.
All news, all the time. This is 1010 Wings.
Good morning, 68 degrees at 6 o'clock. It's Wednesday, August 24th.
All the time. This is 1010 Wins.
Good morning, 72 degrees at 6 o'clock. It is Thursday, August 25th. Here's what's happening. A 6-alarm fire burns down 7 houses. Two members of the U.S. Olympic swim team being held in Brazil. With a shower and thunderstorm in a few places, high of 90. Clinton campaigns unleashing a new campaign ad today. NYPD still hasn't given a motive for the killing of any immigrants, but with Election Day closing in...
Danny boy, the pipes.
Danny? I was up all night.
Hello?
Uh-huh.
What are you doing?
It's almost 7.
Got a show in at noon today.
Yeah.
Did you ever get hold of her?
Uh-huh.
Morning.
Hey, kiddo.
Morning.
Why did I get a license if I can't get a car?
School starts next week, right?
Mm-hmm.
Syracuse application. Early admissions due.
I spoke to Chris Simpson about a referral.
Most of my friends are going to state.
What? Danny, you worked your butt off for this.
This is your next assignment.
Ongoing at the Brooklyn Botanical Garden.
Okay, what chapter are you on?
Halfway through 5.
Part where they almost killed that kid.
You know that I can get through on my own now.
We made it this far, kid.
You want to write the book report, too?
Couple things, 350 buys the keys to their dream home.
Yeah.
Can you show it to us at midnight?
Midnight?
And the school we saw yesterday, yes, it was private, but it's worth it.
Uh-huh. You seen these estimates for tuition?
And that doesn't include room and board.
What?
We'll find a way, we always do. It's got to be.
Okay, Wednesday?
Unless it's written on a piece of paper that she can hand you.
I listen.
I will not forget the look in your... I'm sorry. I love you.
I sort of like you.
$10,000 a year? Sweetheart, it ain't MIT, it's preschool.
What now?
Wuthering Heights, Charlotte Bronte.
Emily.
Emily?
Yeah.
Well, I would not forget that face. I think we locked eyes one time. It was like, boom, you know?
You know, my son's on me to retire. I don't know. Maybe. Every day's a grind.
Begins to feel like a countdown. This way in the morning, that way at night.
And then one day it's done with you.
What's that?
Life.
All right, see you on the next go-round.
Take it easy. My father died when he was 43. Left me, my mom, my brothers with mountains of debt.
Thank you.
I moved here from Ireland with nothing. Made a life for myself, my family. That's the reason I do what I do. To protect young families like yours. I will tell you this. My wife, Karen, and I, we worked hard, did everything right. 401k, investments, my son's education fund. In 2008, we lost it all. Second mortgage was due. We liquidated our assets, cut every piece of fat. When the banks, Wall Street, got rich. The one thing we didn't cut was our life insurance policy. With the high rate. But I know you too well. 20 may not even cut it. Hey, Jeannie, would you pull Jared Carlson's LTC policy?
Sure.
I'll look over it and give you a call later today, okay?
Alex Murphy called. From drinks at Patty O'Brien's on 44th.
Thank you. You can always reach out to Weber and Finch. Yes.
Hey, Mike. I talk to you a sec?
Sure.
My office.
John, listen, I'm gonna have... 10 years. Just like that.
Your severance package. Corporate is switching from a financial buyout to a medical extension.
You're giving me insurance, Frank.
Medical's covered for your family. Unemployment should subsidize.
Karen and me, we're hand to mouth.
You call HR anytime. They'll answer any questions you have.
I've got two mortgages. A son who's going to college. And 5 years from retirement. I'm 60 years of age, Frank.
It isn't personal, Mike. Your salary benefit package is too much against your return. You work hard, you play by the rules, you're a good soldier, and you don't deserve it. But the reality is, sometimes soldiers end up casualties.
Good. What's going on, sweetheart?
I didn't want to bother you, but did you happen to go by the bank today?
No, I thought we were going to wait.
Yeah, until this week. We talked about this? Danny has to register for classes. If we don't get an extension on the mortgage, neither check clears. I mailed the tuition check this morning. Is everything okay?
Yeah. Just in the middle of it, you know, same old.
Okay, honey. I'll see you tonight.
Yep. Bye.
Sorry I'm late.
Hey, there he is.
How you doing?
How long you been at it?
Only since security escorted me from my building. Cheers.
Oh, no.
Mm-hmm. Hey, two more for him.
So how'd Karen take it? You haven't told her?
What am I supposed to say?
I don't know, man. It's some asshole suit just fired me.
She doesn't know how bad it is. We've got nothing to fall back on. 10 years, you build a home, a life, a career. And then one day they set you down. It's been a good run. Thanks for playing. See you at the eulogy.
You want proof you're a good man? Take a look at your family. That's what matters.
Yeah.
You gave up the job for them. Don't forget that. For 7 years we were partners. You always have my back. So let someone else have yours for once. All right. Well, you could have ended up like me. 45, divorced. Kids hate my guts.
If it was 45 again.
Yeah, it's a good thing you got out. It ain't just cops being cops anymore, you know? It's politics, favors, choose a goddamn side.
Sergeant Hawthorne.
No, Captain Hawthorne.
What?
Yeah, he made captain. Guys like you and me, Mike, we work hard, we do it right, it doesn't matter.
A city planning official commits suicide after the DA announces an investigation amid swirling accusations of illicit payoff for the approval.
It's a corrupt world, my friend. No good being the little guy.
is coming over.
Mm. Here we go. Michael.
David.
Been a while.
Yeah. Captain David, congrats.
Well, I'll spend more time in City Hall than I do on the job. That goes with the stripes.
Yeah.
Still selling insurance?
Yep.
Sorry to interrupt.
No.
Lieutenant, a word?
Oh, Cap, I just pulled a 12-hour back-to-back. Can it wait?
Sure. Anyway, good to see you, Mike.
Yeah, you too, David.
Be careful of this one.
Yeah, I will.
Yeah, you brick. Listen, the Michael I know, he doesn't hide things from his wife, and he isn't too proud to ask a friend for help.
I'll be fine.
That's your Irish pride talking.
You should know.
I gotta go pick up my kid. Don't you have a train to catch?
Yes. Jim, what's the damn
thing? No, I got it. Promise me that when you get home, you'll tell Karen.
What? Did you finally pay for something?
What's the old Irish saying? If you want to know what God thinks about money, look at who he gives it to.
Look at who he gives it to.
Yeah.
I'll catch you. Jim, I'll catch you.
Doing bag checks at goddamn rush hour.
Step forward, ma'am. Sure. Thank you very much.
You know, if something's ticking, let it through.
Forward, sir. Open up.
See the backpack, please.
Can't do it.
No, thank you very much. Step forward.
Hey, Mike, you want to do me a quick deal on some insurance before I have a friggin' heart attack here?
Sir, you're back, please. Thank you.
Suspicious or unattended package, please bring
one or notify. Hey, which way you going?
Already on the train. If it's gonna happen at all, it's gonna happen tonight. No more excuses.
Hey, Wolf.
You get me a name?
What?
Well, that woman's staring at you like she knows something we don't.
I don't see anybody.
Everything all right?
Yeah. Try the next car.
No, I've got to take a leak. My prostate's bigger than your head.
Noche sin dormir, tía, que me va a dar algo. Que no sé qué hacer.
Look, Manny, I'm telling you. The lines are fine, but there's no power. Have a fix it when we get in, okay?
What if I try this?
Oh, Jesus, Jimmy, come on.
Hey, I did nothing.
Hey, Tarrytown. AC's out in this coach. You get a seat up front while you can.
You look worn out, Sam.
Yeah, 32 years. The train don't kill me. The people will.
Tell me about it.
Don't stop it.
Now that's exactly why I never got married.
By low tonight.
What?
Are you serious? I said, are you serious? Is it Gives and Hawks suit? Does that mean anything to you?
Of course it doesn't.
Yeah.
Tuesday, Wednesday.
If he's a piker, get rid of him. Wipe it off the table, put it in the trash. Find someone to trade sides.
Now this gives me a few money.
I call it big. Can't afford a suit, you don't get it. I told him.
Tickets, please. Let me get them.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. You got a ticket there, young lady? You buy a ticket on the train, I gotta charge you a penalty.
It sucks. I know. Tell me about it. Your regrets. Tickets out, everybody.
Thanks, Gordon. Thank you very
Knicks
much.
Knicks game. Knicks game.
Hey, get your feet off the seat there, sweetheart.
Shane.
You got a ticket?
Goddamn Shane. Shut your mouth. Of course I know what I'm talking about. How many years have I been doing this? Tell me.
Do you mind?
I mind your 99 cent perfume.
Thanks, guys.
No, now I'm talking.
Thank you.
Come on, come on.
Bye-bye.
Go ahead. Send it through. I'm looking at the numbers now.
Now arriving 58th Street.
Steinbeck, huh? Some say his greatest work was a letter he wrote to his son. Your book.
Right. I beg your pardon.
Thank you. It's my first time on a commuter train. It's eclectic. What about you?
Every day, last 10 years.
10 years? You must know everyone on this train.
The regular commuters, I guess. Faces, mostly. I'm sorry, have we met?
No, I'm Joanna.
Michael.
Michael. How long is it between stops? 4 minutes?
Yeah, give or take.
4 minutes? On and off, on and off. It's so miscellaneous. I'm bothering you, aren't I?
No.
I am. I just want to read your book.
I'm married.
Oh, me too.
Sorry.
I study human behavior. It's an occupational hazard.
Being married?
No, bothering people.
Oh.
I'm a conversationalist.
So, in your job, you sit down, strike up a conversation, then what?
Okay, let's say there are 100 people in this car. There are 16 personality types, as defined by psychology. Right, so I can assume that there are about 6 people of each type, with varying degrees of response to any particular situation. My job is to answer one basic question.
What's that?
What kind of person are you?
Me? Should probably ask my wife.
Let's do an experiment.
Experiment.
It's painless. It's just a simple hypothetical question.
Okay.
What if I asked you to do one little thing? It's something that you are uniquely qualified to do. It's something that's meaningless to you, but it could profoundly affect an individual on this train. Would you do it?
I'd want to know what kind of thing.
Does it matter?
Well, I think it does.
And you would never know the consequences of what you did.
Then why would I do it?
Because there would be a reward.
Uh-huh. So, what's the reward?
In the bathroom, carriage 2. Maybe there is a package. It's hidden. And inside that package is $25,000. That money is yours, plus another 75 cash. If you do this one little thing.
I don't understand.
Someone on this train does not belong. All you have to do is find them. That's it. This person is carrying a bag. You don't know what it looks like, but inside that bag is something they have stolen. This person goes by the name of Prin. It's not a real name. They will be on this train until Cold Spring. You find them, you find the bag, that $100,000 is yours. Don't leave the train before finding the bag. Don't tell anyone about this offer.
Wait a minute.
Simple.
I thought this was hypothetical.
It's just one little thing. Shouldn't be too hard for next cop.
Wait, how did you know it?
Oh, that's me.
You're being serious, right?
You have until next stop to decide. What kind of person are you?
Kidding me.
Anybody, I'm not taking it.
Excuse me.
You're gonna want to move on, pal. The AC's out in here.
Actually, I was hoping you could help me. I'm looking for someone, a friend.
Okay.
They're going to Cold Spring, and I was wondering if you keep track of where everyone gets on and off the train.
Yeah, I take pictures, I hand out surveys, you know?
I didn't mean it like that.
Dude, it's tickets and zones, okay? They buy a ticket for a station, I punch the zone stub, and put it on the seat. Boom.
Is that just day riders, or?
You said you're looking for your friend, right?
Yeah.
You don't know what they look like? You're asking me questions about passengers, about protocol.
I know it's stupid. We only talked online. She said she'd be here. Lives in Cold Spring.
You mean an online date? On a metro train? Yeah, I can't help you, pal. No one can. All right. You take it easy. Good luck.
Now arriving on the 10th Street Station.
you Michael? Michael McCauley?
Yeah.
You found what you're looking for?
What?
No, are we doing this?
No. No, I can't.
Yeah, they thought you might say that.
Wait a minute. What is this?
It's a warning. In case you haven't figured it out yet, they're watching you.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. There's no service till 125th. Sometimes in the back, if you want. Don't quit out of my game.
You figure out who she was? The woman we saw earlier that was eyeballing you. Now, I figure that's where you went, looking for her. Hey, no judgment.
If I borrow the sports section?
No, yeah, sure.
Yeah. Thanks.
Yanks are playing the Sox.
Uh-huh.
5 wins to clinch. I'm feeling very confident.
You know, my boy, he won't let me watch it on TV. He says it's bad for my blood pressure. As if the Yanks winning would give me a heart attack or something. Don't know why the kid is so worried. Kid spends more time watching me than he does at work. Yeah, and that is what I get for teaching a kid to do the right thing. Well, listen, I'm going to stop by a bar and get a beer. Why don't you come with me?
I can't. I got to make a call. Please, it's an emergency. I'm a friend. Hey, Murph, it's Michael. Listen, I'm on this train just before Harlem. I don't know what the hell's happening. This woman approached me out of nowhere. She wants me to find a passenger carrying some kind of bag. Murph, I think I've... Just send someone to my house and call me back at this number, okay?
See you on the next go-round.
Folks, we're stopping due to a red signal. We should be on our way in just a few minutes.
What the hell is this?
Look outside. Corner of MLK and Lexington. Quickly now. Southeast corner.
What do you want from me?
I want you to accept responsibility. We all suffer the burden of choice. No one forced you to take that money. Do you see him? We can't have your friends talking to the police.
I didn't tell them anything.
We both know that's not true.
What?
Oh my God. What have you done?
You did this. You made your choice. Find Prin, find the bag, or there will be further consequences.
You see what happened?
You listen to me. Listen.
No, you listen. I can get to anyone, anywhere. Your wife, Karen. Your son, Danny.
You touch my wife, my son. I swear to God.
I asked you to do one little thing. Don't make it more complicated than that. Don't make me hurt someone you love.
Wait. The day riders all have ticket stubs in the back of their seats. I can narrow down which passengers are going to Cold Spring.
Now we're getting somewhere.
What's in the bag? What do I do when I find it?
Check your right jacket pocket. Do you know what that is?
It's a GPS tracker.
Clearly your time as a police officer wasn't for nothing. Plant the device on the bag and it's all over. Dobbs Ferry Station, that's three stops, arrives 7 p.m. And Michael?
What?
Give the gentleman back his phone.
You know he's sitting here. Excuse me, does this train go to Ten Mile River?
Yeah.
Ah, I thought that. Thank you. Couldn't help but overhear earlier. You're a broker, right?
Can I help you with something?
I haven't seen you on the train before.
There's a reason for that.
You riding for business or... Well, my wife and I are getting ready to retire, and we're looking for a new broker.
I work for one of the largest investment banks in the world.
Great, that's exactly...
We don't represent people like you.
You're headed to Cold Spring. I figured maybe you were seeing a client out there.
What makes you think I'm going to Cold Spring?
I don't know.
What's your deal, man? Let me guess. Suit, the shoes, the watch. You probably worked sales the last 20 years. Now you want to turn your nest egg into a 3-week timeshare in Maui. Yeah. Nah, they got me on a train to nowhere. Seriously, I never should have left Goldman Sachs.
Hey, Goldman Sachs, on behalf of the American middle class, fuck you.
Sorry, Matt, go ahead. Nah, there's nothing.
Wrong day, huh?
time, Sherry.
Yeah. But you've been busy, huh? Up and down the aisle the whole time?
Karen's been on me to get more exercises, either the train or Pilates.
How is the family?
Good, good. Danny's headed off to Syracuse.
Wow, you must be really proud.
Yeah, he's trying to decide between the dorms or an apartment, or the dorms or an apartment. Excuse me. Hello. You go to Columbia, right? T-shirt. Are you a photography student? I noticed your camera case.
I don't know. I'm sorry.
Millennials, huh?
Excuse me, if you just wait.
I
only want to talk.
What are you doing? Are you crazy?
What is this?
Nothing. Can you just stop it?
Fake IDs?
They're not mine, I swear to God. They're my boyfriend's, and he asked me if I could carry it because he would get caught. Are you a cop?
No, I'm not a cop. But listen, if he really cared about you, he wouldn't ask you to do something like this.
You okay?
Now leaving Knoxville. Next stop, Tarrytown.
Sure.
Maybe it's nothing. Look, they were all sitting together, three of them.
Right.
And 125th is split up, each to a different car. I don't know, it felt weird.
I'm only authorized to search a bag if it's been left behind.
You know I ride this line every day. Like I said, maybe it's nothing. But see something, say something, right?
You point them out to me.
Yeah. Woman
there.
Nurse. Man in the second car. African American with a guitar. Another in the last car. All going to Cold Spring.
Security checks, and I just need to take a look at your bag.
Why?
I just need to take a look at your bag.
Hey, this is what you were doing.
It's a random security check. Get back to your books, get back to your notes. I just need to take a look at your bag. I just told you, ma'am. It's a random security check. Now, do me a favor, will you? Just open your bag. I'm sorry.
No.
Just open up your bag, and I'll be on my way.
I had a visual, but I can't get to anything yet. We just need a bit more time.
Who are you? Calm down.
Why are you following me?
Are you the reason they're searching passengers?
Friend?
What did you say?
Get off!
You know what's good for you, let it go.
Hey man, you okay?
Yeah.
See that? Scumbag. Tried to steal my wallet.
This train's freaking me out.
Some guy says he's a cop. Now, you don't look so good. Everything all right?
Give me a minute, will you? Murph.
Mike.
You send someone to the house.
Terrytown local, they're on the way. What the hell's going on? Mike.
This woman sits across from me, calls herself Joanna. She offers me $100,000 to find someone on the train. They want his bag.
$100,000? What kind of bag?
I don't know. Look, it sounds crazy. They threatened Karen and Danny. They killed a man, Murph, pushed him into the street.
Jesus Christ. Okay. You still on the train?
Yeah.
All right, don't do anything. I'm gonna call a friend at the Transportation Authority.
I found him, Murph. I didn't have a choice.
What did you do?
They gave me a GPS tracker. The kid's late 20s, black duffel bag, a snakehead tattoo on his neck. Goes by the name of Prin.
Prin? Did you take the money, Mike? You want my help as a detective or as a friend? Because it's two very different things.
What are you not telling me, Murph?
2 nights ago, a buddy of mine in the 9th called a suicide downtown, a staffer in the city planning office. It's all over the news. The thing is, this kid was in deep with the wrong kind of people. There's a witness. Saw two guys dropping 35 stories out a window. Witness goes by Prin.
And I identified him. Someone in this train's gonna kill him. Jesus. I had an altercation with the guy. I got a bag full of cash. Just lost my job. She's trying to set me up.
All right, this is what you're gonna do. Next stop, get off the train.
Murph? Hello? Murph?
You done? Come on, man. What the hell is wrong with you?
Sorry, Tony. Thanks.
Great. Thanks for using my battery up, asshole.
Why are we meeting a witness outside the city? Feels wrong.
20 minutes. All right. I'm checking in with Agent Foster.
As long as the witness gets off that train.
what you did, Michael. Another dead passenger.
This man was a federal agent.
Yes, but he's not Prynne. You marked the wrong man.
You killed him.
Whose fault is that?
I didn't agree to this.
You tell yourself that. I know you think you're a good man, but some part of you was willing. Some part of you capable of condemning a stranger to an unknown fate.
I'm done playing games. I want to talk to my wife.
Stay with me, Michael. You still have a job to do.
I will not do a goddamn thing until I know my wife and my son are okay.
They're just leaving the house now.
Mom, come on. We're gonna be late.
Danny, have you seen my ring? I swear I left it on the bathroom counter.
Have you asked Dad?
He's not picking up his phone as usual.
Mom, who is that?
Danny, get in the car. Lock the door. Can I help you?
Are you Karen McCauley?
Yes.
I'm here because of your husband.
I'm sorry, do I know?
You have a beautiful family, Michael.
There are police on their way right now. If your men
yes,
try anything...
Yes, they were, Michael. They were. Until you called too much attention to yourself.
What?
Look outside. Someone reported a dangerous individual on the train. Now, you're standing over a corpse. Do the math.
What do you want me to do?
Don't leave the train and don't get caught.
I've been doing this a long time, I'm telling you. He's a regular. I don't think he's dangerous.
The guy claims he's looking for someone on board. He makes up some bullshit story about suspicious bags, and then he gets into a fight.
Yeah.
That was impressive, Michael. I almost thought you were going to miss the train.
I want to talk to my wife and my son. I want to know they're safe.
There are two more stops before Cold Spring. Garrison Station is your last chance. If you ever want to talk to them again.
I need more time. There isn't enough to go on.
You've proven yourself capable. Figure it out.
Manny, AC's cut out. I'm gonna check the oven 3.
Copy that.
Hi, excuse me, it's like 90 degrees in here.
Yeah, working on it, man, working on it. Tarrytown, I thought you cut off.
Sam.
You lucky son of a bitch.
My dad said it pays to make new friends. Gonna go again?
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure you've noticed we've lost AC in all cars except the last one. If you want to move, please, remember your belongings. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure you've noticed we've entered the seventh circle of hell. God damn it.
Maravilla,
right to Cold Spring. All right, Coupes, Queens Force.
Hey, Tony, deal me in.
Your money to lose, pal. Come on in, mate.
I got 100 to my name.
All right, Texas Hold'em, good?
Sure.
Okay, gentlemen, take a peek. Doing all right there, pal?
You don't want to know.
You should have got off 2 stops ago.
10 years I ride this train. Maybe one time I want to see the end of the line. What about you, friend?
What about me?
Never seen you on this train before.
Well, I've never seen you either.
You're not a regular.
What is that to you?
All right.
I think your friend here's got a problem with me.
Relax.
Just making conversation, that's all.
Well, if you want to say something, why don't you say it?
It just occurred to me that most of us, we ride this train every day. We nod, we say hello. But how much do we really know about each other?
What about you, Mike? What do we know about you?
Fair enough. If I got fired today. Yeah. Didn't have the guts to tell my wife. Yeah. Have to go home, look my son in the eye. What am I supposed to say? I'm not the man you thought I was. What kind of father? What kind of husband? 60 years old. What have I got left to offer?
Ooh. Extremely honest.
I thought my life sucked.
Are we going to play or what?
Right. I'm out.
So, I heard something earlier today, a hypothetical question.
Uh-huh. What was the question?
What if someone asked you to do one little thing, something that's meaningless to you but would affect another passenger on this train? Would you do it?
I don't know. What's in it for me?
$100,000.
Absolutely.
You don't even know what it is.
It doesn't matter.
So what is that one little thing?
A passenger on this train doesn't belong. They're carrying a bag, but you don't know what it looks like. All you have to do is find them before they get off.
That's it? There's not much to go on, Mike.
Tell me about it.
What happens when you find them?
They die. Hypothetically.
So what would you do, Mike?
I got all the people left in the train in one car. Proposed that very scenario.
No. I mean, would you take the money?
You know what? I already did.
You see, I count five.
Five what?
Five people left that don't belong. Five people on this train that I've never seen before. The lady right here. The young girl with the pink hair at the window. Mr. Goldman Sachs over there. My friend with the guitar. And you.
I'm Jackson. You know what I would do?
Tell me.
I would pocket that 100 grand, find the guy, tell him to take a different train.
All right.
All in.
Oh, whoa. For real? All right.
So, you never answered the question.
What question?
What are you doing on this train?
Maybe I'm like you. Maybe I want to see the end of the line.
Wait, excuse me.
I call.
This is a monthly pass. You're a regular commuter.
Yeah, and I have a full house. Oh, what do you have?
That's it for me. Sorry.
So what if I'm this guy you're talking about?
Are you?
If I was.
Someone wants you dead. I can help you, but I need to know what you know. Why you're going to Cold Spring? What's in that case?
It's just a guitar.
Open it.
You want to help me, why should I trust you?
Open the case. Carriage one. Barricade ourselves inside.
And then what, you gonna find this killer, take him down yourself?
I'm gonna try.
Obviously, I'm not friend. But you seem to have figured that out already.
That's a left-handed guitar.
What's that got to do with it? Hey, man, you okay?
Yeah. The gun's in your right hand.
Well, shit. I guess that's why she chose you. Four passengers left. Which one is it?
I don't know.
All you gotta lose, and you don't know.
You killed that agent.
No, that's on you, man.
How much is she paying you to kill the witness?
Same as you, I guess. That's not really how it works out, is it? No matter how much they pay, you always end up owing more. Who's praying, Michael? Tell me now.
No.
You have no idea who you're up against.
Do you?
Yes, Michael. I do. Drop it.
Take it easy.
Turn around.
You're lying!
Don't be stupid. Stop.
Not until Bren is dead.
I can't let you do that.
Out of time. Who's Prin?
It doesn't matter. Your guy's dead.
You have the gun? Take it, Michael. Take the weapon. Kill Prin. Retrieve the bag. And your family lives.
I am not gonna do this.
You can't have it both ways. You can save the witness or your family. You know who Prin is, don't you? It's time to finish what you started.
Now arriving garrison, folks.
Hey, Mike, what happened to the guy with the guitar?
He got off.
I better not be staying in bed and breakfast this time, huh? No way.
All that's left is you.
What?
Why are you going to Cold Spring?
That's
none of your business.
What's in the bag?
My God, what is with you people and my bag? Jeez. Hey. What are you doing? Let go of me.
I'm trying to help.
Seriously, come on, do something!
Who is that?
What's your problem?
Mike, you gotta let the lady go.
You don't get it, do you? She wants you dead. You witnessed a murder. You have something that she wants. Something she's willing to kill for.
Okay, Mike, you gotta let her go, Mike. Let the lady go. Mike!
Hand me the phone!
Mike, come on.
Mike, don't move! Stay in your seats. Please, hand me the phone.
Your problem is, but I am not the person you're looking for, okay? My boyfriend and I, we had this huge fight because I wasn't sure about staying here and us. And so when I finished my shift, I just didn't want to go home.
Forgive me. Take it. I'm sorry. They're gonna kill my family. There's no one else. Six-day riders. Six ticket stubs. Six going to Cold Spring. Except... one got off at Garrison. Goldman Sachs. He was in the aisle. He switched seats.
Prynne. Hester Prynne.
The Scarlet Letter, of course.
You bought the ticket to Cold Spring.
End of the line. Cold Spring coming up.
Is it done? Is it done?
I will not do this.
I thought I had you figured out. I really did.
Manny?
After all of this, you would choose the life of a stranger over your own family? You must think you're some kind of a hero.
I won't do this. I won't do it. I will not do this.
Manny, we have a hostage situation.
Calling dispatch.
This is your last chance, Michael. Do it.
No.
Prynne has evidence of a conspiracy.
It doesn't matter.
People I work for, they will do anything to protect us.
What?
These are very powerful people. They'll do whatever
they?
It takes.
Who are you talking
Even
about?
Kill you, your family, everyone on that train. Do you understand?
Who's they?
You have made your choice.
Joanna, who are you working for?
Now everyone dies.
Hello.
Dispatch is contacting the police.
Stop the train.
Copy that.
You want to live? You stop this goddamn train now. Pull the brake. Now.
All right. Now, everyone, hang on.
Yeah, thanks. Train's less than a minute away.
Marshal Service ready for us. Take the statement at the safe house, no screwing around.
Why is it not stopping?
I don't know.
Sal, I swear I had nothing to do with this.
Manny!
Oh, man, that's not good.
Oh, my God. Come and get this open! Jammed!
Dispatch is gonna clear the tracks.
What?
There's a curve just before Beacon. Now, we hit it at 70 miles an hour. We're gonna derail for sure.
All the passengers are in the last car. Can we detach it?
We have to try. Come on. We gotta unhook the couplers. There's a coupler safety latch. It can only be released from underneath the car. Someone will have to pull the knuckle bit. And one of us will have to go down and release the latch.
No! No freaking way! I'm not going down there!
It's just outside!
I don't care! Shut up!
Just outside
down
and down the ladder!
I'll do it!
Yeah, you do it!
Look, you go tell the passengers to brace themselves!
I'll do that!
We got about 2 minutes! You make them count!
Stay calm! Stay calm, okay? Stay calm! Remain calm!
Why?
I don't have time to argue with you, lady. You sit down. All right, take your seat. Everyone, sit down. Sit down.
I am sitting down.
Caught. leverage. I'll get the axe. Between the trade and the people, I always knew it'd be the trade.
Train. Please, listen!
Get the door open!
You gotta get out!
Jackson, close the door. This isn't over yet. We're still in danger. Everyone, grab a newspaper. Cover the windows. Use water, soda, anything.
Mike, this is crazy.
Come on, get some water. Cover the windows.
Why are we doing this, Mike?
Just do it! We don't know who's out there. Who's watching? They tried to kill us all.
You right?
I know you're all scared, but I need your help. None of you can leave. Not yet. Not until I know everyone's safe. They murdered innocent people. They derailed the train. They did this. All to find a witness. Something she has that they want. They said if I didn't kill you, they would kill my wife, my son. But I would never do what these people want. I need your help. I need to know why they want you dead. What's your name?
Sophia.
Sophia. It's okay. Come here. I'm not gonna let them hurt you, okay? Can you show me what's in your bag? This is what they want? Do you know why?
My cousin Enrique. It was his.
The guy who threw himself off the 35th floor.
Ricky didn't kill himself.
You were there when he died? It's okay. Tell me. Tell me what you saw.
Ricky was a city planner. And some nights he would have to work late. So I would go to his office to finish my homework. I was waiting for Ricky by the elevator when these two men show up. I didn't see their faces, but they were looking for Ricky. I hid because I didn't want to get him in trouble. But they wanted something from him. And then all of them start yelling, and I hear this noise. They were hurting him. I could hear him screaming, and he tells me that he doesn't have it, that it's back at his place.
You took it?
Of course I took it. I wanted to help. And then I look through the doorway, and I see this guy. He's holding Ricky, and he hits him. And he says something about being noble.
Noble?
He says that doing the right thing will get you killed, and that there's no such thing as being noble. And then they just... I didn't know what to do.
I know.
I just took it and I ran.
Why didn't you call the police?
I couldn't call the police. The men who killed him were cops.
Oh my god.
The next day I went to a friend's, and she knew someone in the FBI. This guy, Agent Garcia, he says that this drive is evidence. And that I'm a witness. He says it's not safe for me in the city anymore. He tells me to catch the 625 to Cold Spring, then they'll protect me.
You told no one else?
No.
Your friend trusts this Agent Garcia, yeah?
I don't know.
Someone out there wants you to disappear. I know it's not him. Who?
Macaulay.
This is Captain David Hawthorne.
I'm in command.
We have the train surrounded. There is nowhere for you to go.
Clear.
Throw out your weapon. My men will come aboard. They will escort the hostages to safety.
It's okay. Don't be alarmed.
You will not be harmed.
This is normal police procedure. It's okay. You'll all be safe.
No one will be harmed.
Jesus, there's a freaking army out there.
Agent Garcia, come to me. I need tactical staged and ready to breach, okay?
So.
Thanks. Where's Overwatch?
Overwatch, this is command.
When you get line of sight, I need to know.
Roger.
This is bad, Mike.
It'll be fine, I promise.
Macaulay. You have an old friend here. He wants to come aboard. He wants to talk.
Your tag is lit.
We are live outside the town of Beacon, where a Hudson North train has derailed. No reports of any casualties yet.
We're back. Go, go, go. We're back. Go, go.
We got sound on Lieutenant Murphy.
According to our source on the ground, an ex-NYPD officer has taken over the train and is holding the passengers hostage.
Hey, Mike, how we doing in there? Listen, man, you know how this goes. We don't work this out. SWAT's gonna take the train by force. Well, talk to me, buddy.
Where's my family? You said police
were on their way. They were, man. I don't know what happened.
Look, we're doing the best we can.
You don't know what's going on, Murph.
Then tell me. All right? Just open the door and let me in. I'm unarmed. I'm alone. How many people you got in there? Mike, I want to help you. You got to help me out. If I don't produce results, they're going to pull me out. Now, how many hostages do you have?
We got to do something.
Yeah, but what? What can we do?
15? 20?
All right, just let some go. Whoever you want.
How do I know they'll be safe?
The hostages?
There's someone I need to protect.
Look, if you're worried about someone's safety, just set them out with me.
Not yet.
No. 7 years we were partners, you always had my back. Let someone else have yours for once.
Mike!
Look, I tell you what, I'll make an exchange.
Okay, release some hostages and take me instead.
They're coming out.
Okay, come on out. Come on out.
Alright, watch your step. Go that way. Right, follow her. Right, stay in the line.
Yes, it does appear that hostages are being released. It is unclear at this time how many remain on the train.
Is that it?
Yeah, come on.
Patrol's on the way to your house. No sirens.
They have you tagged.
This goes on much longer. They're gonna board. They don't want a cop caught in the crossfire.
Come on, put the gun down. Jesus, I'm unarmed. Come on.
Tell them to turn the lights off.
Kill the lights.
Cut the lights. Thanks, pal.
Come on, you know the deal.
We lost audio.
You were right. There is a witness on the train. They were supposed to meet the FBI at Cold Spring.
FBI? Special Agent Garcia?
You know.
Hawthorne just pulled jurisdiction from him.
Hawthorne, that figures.
I want eyes on.
Confirm visuals.
Friendly, fire tag is lit in blue. Visual confirmed.
Mike, what the hell happened? I talked to you. Next thing I know, you're taking people hostage.
They killed three passengers, including a fat. They derailed the train. All to get some evidence.
Okay. So where is it, Mike?
Not until Karen and Danny are safe.
Local PD's calling me directly.
So, we wait.
We wait. How you guys doing?
Yeah, I'm good.
Not too bad.
Oh, perfect.
Fine, but I gotta pee.
Mike, I know this isn't you, man. Look, you say they set you up. You got a witness, evidence. I believe you, but...
But what?
It doesn't matter what I believe. It's what I can prove. Look, you want confirmation on your family, I understand. But from where I sit, I say we end this thing right now. Just give me what you got. Nobody else has to get hurt.
You telling me that as a detective or a friend?
I don't know, Mike. What would you tell me? We're running out of time, man. Mike, I get it. You want to do the noble thing here, but I got news for you. There ain't no such thing as noble.
was you.
What are you talking about?
You called me. You knew about the witness. You knew what they saw.
Yeah, I told you what happened.
It was a cop who killed him. You set me up.
Hey, slow down, Mike.
You killed Enrique Mendez. You knew Prim was getting on this train. You targeted me.
Mike.
An ex-cop rides this train every day. You knew.
Mike, whoever's talking to you, they're trying to get in your...
man. Talk, goddammit, talk.
Friendlies engage with the target. I repeat, friendlies engage with the target.
Do not fire until you get a clear shot.
Dad, say what? That you killed three people? A fed? You derailed a train and took the passengers hostage all because some mystery woman threatened
you
your family?
You did this.
Doesn't look that way, does it? So why don't you put down the gun before someone you love gets hurt?
Where are they? Where's my family? I will kill you, all right, Murph, I swear to God.
Okay. I'm trying to help you here. A lot of powerful people have got a lot to lose if that evidence gets out. They have eyes everywhere. Even inside the Bureau. I told them to put the witness on your train. I thought I was doing you a favor. You needed the money. But you couldn't just do what she asked, could you? If I don't answer that, your family dies. So why don't you give me the gun? You got no choice, Mike. It doesn't have to end this way. Karen, Danny.
Don't you dare say their names.
You've done enough, Mike.
Is it done?
We're good.
You know what to do.
See, the thing is, Mike, I got a family too, you know. All right, who's Prim?
Murph, listen to me.
All I gotta do is call her back, Mike. Come on. All right, who's Prim? Who's Prim? Mike. Who's Prim? Who's Prim?
It's me. I'm Prim.
No, man. She's calling for me. I'm Prim.
Wait. I'm the witness. I'm Prim.
No. I'm Prim.
They're lying.
I'm Prim, and I know what you did, you bastard.
I am not Prim. So.
No one is.
It's gotta be someone.
You got a shot, take him out.
Roger.
Leave it!
Watch, do you have a shot?
Repeat, do you have a shot?
Negative.
Watch the hostages.
Watch the friendly.
Holding fire.
What are you gonna do? Kill all of us?
No, you are.
Target is clear.
Take him out.
McCauley? Michael McCauley?
Yeah.
I'm Agent Garcia, FBI. Your family's safe. We arrested three men outside your home. He was your cousin? Tell me what you saw.
So this is the end of the line?
I guess so.
Next time I'm taking the bus.
All I know is this, all right? That guy's a goddamn hero, okay? A hero, write that down.
Yeah.
H-E-R-O, hero. A hero, did you write it?
Hero.
Thank you. You got every
So what's up? You got a boyfriend or what?
Yeah?
Yeah? Is it serious? I wanna know what I'm dealing with.
Hi, darling.
Hey, babe.
Oh my God, look at you. Are you okay?
I'm all right. Hey, big guy.
Hey, Dad.
How you doing? Oh, Mrs. McCauley, I believe you may have lost this.
Been looking for this all day. Should we get you home?
Yeah, let's go.
So, this is what you do every day when you go to work, huh?
Yeah, every day. Come on, help me up.
I can't believe what they're saying. Is it really true about Murph?
Give me a second, will you? Give me a second. David, I have to tell you, there's been an ongoing investigation into Alex Murphy and others in the department. There was a woman, female, mid-30s. We're checking CCTV in and around 86th Street, right? Yeah. When we know, you'll know. What can I say? I'm sorry it got this far. Listen, Mike. We miss guys like you in the department. Guys that do it right.
More details are emerging now in the wake of that Hudson North derailment.
A federal witness reportedly turned over evidence to authorities on the train crash.
Several NYPD officers have been implicated. There is no
evidence. Beginning with the murder of a city planning official.
He attempted to blow the whistle on a conspiracy, which could possibly lead
to City Hall, to the mayor's office.
About accusations of collusion.
And now a link between city officials and at least three
on a major scale. And this mystery woman who masterminded the derailment, does she even exist?
A man is what he does when the storm comes. Alexandre Dumas. Read that one a few years back. It's got a hell of an ending.
The seat taken.
The 6:20 every morning to Chicago, the 5:30 home. You know, I never took you for a commuter.
I'm sorry, have we met?
The way I figure it, the people you work for, Alex Murphy goes down, you win. That 16-year-old girl dies on that train, you win. You do your job, disappear, the rest of us, just collateral damage. You didn't pick me because the witness was on my train. You put her on the train. Maybe you even got me fired. Suddenly I have motive, opportunity, just like Alex Murphy.
This wasn't his operation. You played us both.
I'm not sure what you think is going to happen here, Michael.
One little thing.
What's that?